The men slid back into view on the ice rink in Baselga de Pinè, with the sunshine once again out in force for their fourth event of this Universiade, the 1,000 metres. Sung Ching-yang of Chinese Taipei may only have managed a single points finish in this year's World Cup in this event, but will be going on to represent his country in both the 500 and 1,000 metres at the Olympics in Sochi next February. He was paired up with home hope Yan Daldossi, whose sister Yvonne Daldossi tripped on the start line in the second round of the women's 500 metres here in Trentino, having taken a slender lead from the first round, going on to finish in a lowly 17th place. Yan himself had only managed an 18th place finish in the 1,500 metres on Sunday. Sung getting very much the better start of these two though, and with a point to prove after failing to register a time in the 500 metres on Saturday, and trailing in 28th place in the 1500. Sung starting like a bullet, then grimly hanging on around the final lap, setting a time of 1 minute 10.64 seconds to grab himself a spot on the podium, while Daldossi would ultimately finish in 10th. Jan Marek Szymański has been one of the stories of this Universiade, and most certainly the star turn for the speed skaters. He'd already become the first Pole to ever win a medal in the 5,000 metres on his way to gold, and then managed to repeat that trick in the 1,500 metres on Sunday. Now, the 24-year-old from the University School of Physical Education in Poznan was going for a golden triple in the 1,000 metres and was up against even Simon Johansson. The Norwegian finished only 40th in the 2011 World Championships, but was managing to keep up with Szymański in the early stages here, even leading the way around the opening lap before the pole started to crank his way through the gears. Johansson, in fact, would fall foul of the judges in this one, clipping one of the bollards a lap from the end to be disqualified. Szymański, though, went on to clock a time of 1 minute 10.3 seconds. That would ultimately be just outside the Universiade record, but enough to sit in first place, at least for the moment. But now the moment the crowds had been waiting for, as Mirko Giacomo Nenzi took to the ice. The Italian had already become his country's first ever medalist in the 500 metres on Saturday, taking home a silver medal, and then followed that up by striking silver again in the 1500 metres one day later, behind the dominant Szymański. So the 24-year-old now even more determined to finally drape a gold medal around his neck in the 1,000 metres. This very much his specialist event, having finished in a very rapid 6th place at the Single Distance World Speed Skating Championships earlier this year in Sochi. Keeping Nenzi company in this heat was China's Guo Zhan Tian, the Harbin Institute of Physical Education student, managed 10th in the 1,500 metres, but was never able to even keep close to the Italian. Nenzi, a local lad from the University of Trento, and milking the atmosphere for all he was worth, half a second ahead of Szymański at the first split, and then over a second ahead at the second. And although he did lose a little bit of time on his final lap, Nenzi stopped the clock in 1 minute 9.32 seconds to finally take gold. Delight then for the home fans as Nenzi added a goal to his two silvers on home ice here in Trentino, winning by nearly a whole second. That time also good enough to break his compatriot Enrico Fabrizi's Universiade record, set in Torino 6 years ago on his own way to gold.